Ya, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat berjumpa lagi dengan Tuton, tutor online. Untuk kali ini saya akan menyajikan bagian kedua, yaitu tentang structure and written expression pada soal TOEFL. Ada berbagai macam skills pada sesi ini, bagian ini. Namun untuk Tuton ini akan saya sajikan 5 skill. Apa kelima skill itu? Mari kita perhatikan satu persatu. Yang pertama itu be sure the sentence has a subject and a verb. Artinya apa? Dalam satu kalimat bahasa Inggris ya, in English, the sentence ya consists of at least subject and verb. Dalam hal ini adalah sebagai noun or noun phrase and verb phrase. Kita lihat contoh kalimat di sini misalnya ya. For 3 weeks at the beginning of the semester, students with fewer than the maximum number of units can add additional courses. Bisa kita perhatikan bahwa kalimat satu kalimat panjang ini terdapat subjek dan predikat atau subjek and verb, noun and verb ya. Mari kita amati baik-baik ya. For 3 weeks at the beginning of the semester, ini bukan sebagai subjek, namun ini sebagai keterangan. Subjeknya mana? Tentunya adalah students with fewer than the maximum number of units, atau hanya students ya, but students who ya, who ya, with fewer than the maximum number of units. Nah, ini sebagai fungsi sebagai subject, and after subject is usually followed by verb ya. Nah, which one is the verb? Mana verbnya? Adalah can it. Can ini sebagai auxiliary verb ya. Kemudian the main verb is it. Kemudian, the object is additional courses. Nah, ini yang disebut dengan the sentence has a subject and a verb. Subjectnya adalah students. Verbnya adalah add atau can add. Students with fewer than the maximum number of units. Tetap berfungsi sebagai subject. Okay. The second sentence. On her lunch hour, went to nearby department store to purchase a wedding gift. Berarti kalimat ini apakah sudah lengkap ya? Artinya ada subjek ada verbnya. Coba kita perhatikan ya. On her lunch hour ya, ini kan sebagai keterangan ya. Tidak jauh beda dengan 40 weeks at the beginning of the semester. On her lunch hour no subject. Nah, tapi tiba-tiba ini langsung ketemu dengan when. Nah, when di sini sebenarnya adalah sebagai verb atau kata kerja. Artinya, kalimat ini belum lengkap. Maka perlu ada penambahan subject. Ya, yaitu we need a subject. Kenapa subjeknya she? Karena adalah her. On her lunch hour, nah, we need subject she. She went to nearby department store to purchase a wedding gift. Nah, ini contoh simple dua kalimat ya, that the sentence has a subject and a verb. Example ya, kita contohnya, blah 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 was backed up for miles on the freeway. Nah, kira-kira kalimat ini perlu tambahan apa nih? Was-nya udah ada, was back up ya, artinya ini sebagai verb ya. Jadi yang diperlukan adalah subject. Begitu juga karena verb-nya ini adalah singular ya, maka diperlukan subject yang sesuai dengan verb ini. Yesterday adalah sebagai keterangan ya, tidak mungkin sebagai pelengkap di sini. In the morning juga sama. Tadi ada dua noun ya, ada dua noun, traffic sama cars. Nah, kalau cars ini plural, harusnya pakai were. Nah, kanan ini was, so the correct one is traffic. Oke, skill 2, be careful of object of preposition. Example ya, with his friend, bla bla bla, found the movie theater. Nah, tadi dengan object preposition, with his friend ini adalah sebagai keterangan, bukan sebagai subjek. Karena with his friend, artinya ini membutuhkan subjek. Subjek yang mana? Has is not a subject. He, this is the correct one, ya. Yeah? Letter and when, not subject. So the correct one is B. Clear ya? Yeah? Skill 3, be careful of a positive. Ya. Yeah? What's a positive? Yaitu kata yang mendahului ya. Misalnya begini, Shelly, the best student in the class, got an A on the exam. Nah, artinya apa? Shelly ya, the student best student in the class ya. Nah, artinya apa? Ini adalah sebagai bentuk keterangan dari Shelly. Who is Shelly? The best student in the class. Nah, means the subject is Shelly. Ya, oke. Okay. Sally, the best student in the class, yeah, got an A on the exam. Okay, pay attention to this example. Eh? Blah, blah, blah. Chose is attending the lecture. Remember, the verb is attending. Chose, yeah, also is the subject. This is kind of the positive. We need certain kind of things refer to Josh. Yeah. Example, right now. Right now is not noun, yeah. Happily also not noun because of the time also, yeah. So the correct one is my friend Josh, yeah. That you call a positive, yeah. Skill 4, be careful of present participle. Present participle means that form in form, yeah, function as the adjective. Jadi bentuk verb ing yang sebenarnya berfungsi sebagai kata kerja meskipun itu tadi kata kerja, yeah. Misalnya begini, the man is talking to his friend. Nah, tapi di sini adalah merupakan suatu action ya, suatu kegiatan yang sedang berlangsung. The man is talking to his friend. The man verbnya adalah sebenarnya is ya, verbnya talk menjadi ing ya. The man is talking to his friend. Nah, the man talking to his friend has a beard ya. Nah, inilah berubah menjadi adjektif ya, talking itu sebenarnya kata sifat ya di sini, because of functions modifies the noun, ini berfungsi menerangkan kata kerja. Who's the man? The man who is talking ya, the man talking to his friend has a bird. So it is not a verb, remember. So which one is the verb? This one has as the verb. The man talking to his friends has the subject as the subject, yeah, and the main verb is has. Okay, look at this example. The child blah 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 playing in the yard is my son. The subject is the child playing in the yard is my son. Now, remember that the verb is here, is the verb, yeah, means that this phrase is from the child to the yard, ya, as the subject, mean that impossible in a sentence there are two verbs, ya. Okay, so the child now or is, ya, he or was. Nah, doesn't like this one, ya. Playing here and function as the adjective modifies the child. So the sentence must be the child now playing in the yard is my son. Right, ya. Okay, good. Skill 5, be careful of the past participle. Now, for this one, that past participle mean that, yeah, people like to say that it can be from the verb 3, yeah, but not always verb 3 is past participle. But we can see example, the family has purchased a television. Here is the verb has purchased, yeah, and the poem was written by Paul. Was written also as the verb, yeah. Was written as the passive one, this participle, yeah. Verb 3 also past participle. Okay, the television purchased yesterday was expensive. mean that function to be the adjective. The television, which is, yeah, or which was purchased yesterday was expensive. The main verb is was. So the function of purchase here as the adjective still modifies the noun. Whatever modifies the noun is the adjective. Apapun yang menerangkan kata benda adalah fungsi sebagai kata sifat. Can I have example? The poem written by Paul appeared in the magazine. Appeared first as the verb. So it is not verb, but it is as the adjective. Masih tetap menerangkan poemnya. Example, the packages blah 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 mail at the post office will arrive Monday. Remember that will arrive here as the main verb, yeah, as the verb will arrive for fresh. So we need this one not the verb, yeah, but at least the package mail at the post office blah blah blah, yeah, mail here as the verb, yeah, but how to be the correct one here? Not have, yeah, not were, yeah, not them, yeah, but the possible answer is just let's see, yeah. Okay, the packages just mail at the post office will arrive Monday. Okay, do this exercise now together, yeah. Let's see number one, correct or incorrect. For correct we write C, for the incorrect we write I. One, for 3 weeks at the beginning of the semester, students with fewer than the maximum number of units can add additional courses. We already discussed this, yeah, if you still remember. So we can see the noun, yeah, as the subject. For 3 weeks at the beginning of the semester, here as the adverb. And the subject is students. Students with fewer than the maximum number of units, and the verb is can add. So this sentence is correct. Okay, number two. On her lunch hour, blah 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 went to a nearby department store to purchase a wedding gift. Remember for this sentence, yeah? On her lunch hour function as the adverb. But remember here went without the subject. So the sentence is incorrect. Okay. Alright, yeah, we need the subject she. Three, the fir trees were grown for the holiday season were harvested in November. Which one the subject? The fir trees, okay. The verb, is it were grown for the holiday season? This is the verb, yeah. It's verb, the main verb, yeah. It means that we doesn't need were here. We omit her, yeah, but to be the first trees grown for the holiday season, yeah, were harvested in November. So this sentence is incorrect. Okay, four. In the grove, the overripe oranges were falling on the ground. Okay, let's see the subject. In the grove, it is as the adverb. The overripe oranges, okay, as the subject. Were falling on the ground, yeah. Were falling as the verb, yeah. So this is correct, okay. Okay, last one. The papers being delivered at 4 will contain the announcement of the president's resignation, yeah. Okay, the subject, the papers, yeah, being delivered at 4, okay, yeah. The paper here is the subject, will contain as the verb, yeah, the announcement of the president's resignation, yeah, in the object. So this sentence is correct. That's our topic today, yeah, for structure. And thank you very much. Semoga bermanfaat. Sampai jumpa di tuton berikutnya.